Welcome back to my channel. This is Nurse Ruth. Today I'm going to be talking about this wonderful plant called aloe vera. It's an amazing plant, that's why I said I must talk about it, and its health benefit, and I'm going to be talking about the uses also. And aloe vera is a universal plant grown all over the world. Is succulent and has a long history of its medicinal uses way back in ancient Egypt for the treatment of various sicknesses and diseases. And nowadays, now aloe vera can be found as aloe vera juice, aloe vera gel, drinks, even in tablets. Now you can get aloe vera in tablets. You can check my description below and you can get it from Amazon too. And aloe vera water, yes, can drink aloe vera water, and even the toothpaste, we have it already. And because of its amazing benefit, that's why different companies are now adding aloe vera to their products. And this supernatural aloe vera is typically used to make topical medications for skin conditions. I've been talking about the skin uses of aloe vera, which is numerous. You can use it to treat your frostbite. It's good for rashes, burns, wounds, cold sores, dry skin, even psoriasis and eczema in babies. You can make your aloe vera paste and use it to treat the affected part. It can also be used to rejuvenate the skin, as it has been proven that it reduces wrinkles, black hairs, as a result of pimples and acne, and it's a good treatment of choice for acne and pimples itself. And cosmetic companies now add aloe vera to products like makeup, moisturizers, shampoo, soaps for the company to get amazing results. So personally, I would advise that aloe vera should be planted at home. It can be planted indoor or outside in the garden as first aid for insect bite or burns. When you want to use it for insect bite, just when you have it in your garden, just take a cut the plant of it, just take out the succulent part of it, and even with the green part, you can rub it on the affected part of the affected area. It gives a soothing effect, so it's very good for your skin, and it's also good for your stretch marks also. You can just add a little bit of that paste, add it to olive oil or add more almond oil. I make sure you get the original almond oil and olive oil. Just apply it regularly for amazing result for about 2 to 3 months, and you'll be sure what you get from your stretch marks because of aloe vera. This aloe vera is very, very good and important. I'll be telling you, if you want to use it for your skin, even you can use it to make to rub your face and just lie down, wait a few minutes to rinse it off, or you can even leave it on your face to dry off on your face, and you sleep with it. The next morning, you see how your face will become rejuvenated just within the night. So aloe vera is very good. It's also good for your hair care. It can be added to conditioner. You add to your conditioner, you make a paste with it to treat your dandruff, your dry hair, your dry scalp, and no dry scalp can cause hair loss. So if you use aloe vera for your scalp, it will no longer be dry. And it can be applied to your hair also. You cover it for some minutes and you rinse off to give your hair its shine and for optimal growth. It can thicken your hair also and thicken your nails. So always look for shampoos or conditioners that has aloe vera if you cannot get aloe vera naturally from the supermarket. But I will advise you to plant yours, grow yours, so that when you need it for this thing, for the skin, for insect bite, for your hair, you can just get it from your garden and create the paste and mix it yourself. With your conditioner, you can use it for your hair. Then also, it's good for your teeth care. Aloe vera can be used to treat dental plaque due to its high dose of vitamin C. So you can add it to your warm water with a pint of salt. and use it to gargle for 2 to 3 times daily for the relief of swollen and bleeding gums and toothache. It can prevent bad breath too. So if you are suffering from any teeth problem, any tooth problem, your gum problem, try using toothpaste that has aloe vera as one of the components. It's also good for hand wash. I've seen it in my supermarket. I always get a hand wash that has aloe vera in it because I know that due to its antibacterial content, it's very good to protect against bacteria and germs, to protect against any hand bacteria. So it's good for your hand wash. So always look for hand wash that has aloe vera in it. It's very good. If you don't want to combine it with alcohol content of a hand wash, just look for aloe vera content. It's antibacterial, so it's very good. So also, studies have also shown that aloe vera can be applied topically on your skin, on your joint, on your ankle to relieve pain, because it has an anti-inflammatory properties. It can be used to relieve osteoarthritis pain. It can also help to boost your immunity too, because it's full of nutrients, amino acids. It contains important minerals and vitamins like vitamin B, C, E, and folic acid, which helps to boost your immunity. Do you know that it's good to know that aloe vera is the only plant source of vitamin B12? No other plant that has vitamin B12, just aloe vera. So it's very good. It's very good to boost your immunity. And the antioxidants help to prevent diseases and infections and sicknesses in general. So never you underestimate the power of aloe vera anymore. Plant it in your house, plant it in your garden. You know that, as I would say, and it is generally said, that prevention is better than cure. So always use aloe vera. Although I will not lie to you, it has a bitter taste, but you can mix it and add it. You as you are seeing that I'm preparing mine, I can add it to your strawberries, add it to your orange juice. If you want to drink it, add other juice with it to help with the taste. And aloe vera is one of the plants like nuts and seeds, roots, vegetables, leafy fruit, greens and fruit that helps to reduce the acidity of the body. Acidic pH is a breeding ground for diseases we all know and illnesses. So always keep your pH balance stable, and aloe vera can help you achieve this. Research has also shown that it's good for gut diseases to alleviate the symptoms of these diseases, and its polysaccharide content can also help fight cancer. Aloe vera has been found that it can be ingested for the relief of constipation, although excess intake can cause diarrhea. Yes, so you have to watch it before you take, when you are taking aloe vera. And research has also shown that it can reduce your blood sugar levels, especially if you are a type 2 diabetes patient, when ingested daily. So if you are on medication, or a permanent medication, or medication that lower blood glucose level, it is advisable to consult with your doctor before taking aloe vera, as it can further decrease your blood glucose level. So my advice is that always start something new. Like I always say in my previous video, always start something new with lithium before you continue, and see if you react to it or not. And always, like I'm going to take it now. I've used it to make my strawberry juice, so I'll just drink it, although the taste is bitter. Yes, so always consult with your doctor. Make sure to buy purified or organic and decolorized aloe vera for use, because it can be, if taken unwise, taken anyhow, it can be dangerous. So always consult your doctor before you, if you're on medication. Thanks for watching my video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't, and hit the notification button for more video, because really I'm really going to be treating lots and lots of good food, fruits, vegetables that can help to boost our immunity, especially in this pandemic. So thank you once again for watching. Thank you. Comment down below if you have any info that will benefit people out there, and give me a thumbs up. And thank you for watching. See you at the top. Bye.